In today's video, I'm gonna show you how to make a nice typewriter text effect inside DaVinci Resolve. So let's get right into it. So I already have a timeline open and this old paper texture background waiting, and this effect is very easy to do. All you have to do is go to Effects, then Titles, and drag and drop this text plus into the timeline. Remember, the text doesn't work, it has to be text plus. So let's drop it into the timeline, make it the size of our B-roll, and now we're gonna customize it. So now we'll come to Inspector, and if it's not open, all you have to do is click on this button right here. We're gonna change the title to, let's say, typewriter text effect. Now I'm gonna change the font to something more appropriate. So I've downloaded a font exclusively for this effect, and it's called X Typewriter. I'm gonna leave the link for the free download of this font in the description of the video. Now I'm gonna change it from white to black, and from regular to bold. And there are many things we can do here. We can change the size, make it larger or smaller. We can also change the tracking, which is basically the space between characters. We can change the line spacing, which we don't need right now, since we only have one line of text. And we can also change many other properties. Okay, our customization is ready. So now, since it's a still background, I'm gonna give it some movement. And I'm gonna do that by selecting the background, then I'll come to the transform section inside Inspector, and I'm gonna set a keyframe here in this zoom. And if you don't know what a keyframe is, it's basically this little diamond right here. And what it does is basically tell the software that we want a specific effect to happen at a specific point in our clip. So now, I'm telling Resolve that at this point in time, the scale will be at 1. Now I'm gonna come to the end of the clip, go back one frame, and I don't even have to set another keyframe. I can simply type 1.1 and boom, it automatically sets the keyframe here. So let's see how it looks. Okay, now I'll have to do the same with the text. So select the text, come to settings, set a keyframe, go to the end, go back one frame, type 1.1. Now the text will follow along the movement of the background. Let's see how it goes. Now it's time for the typewriter effect. So making sure the text is selected, we'll go to the beginning of the text, we're gonna come to title, and we're gonna scroll down all the way until we see this right on right here. And as you can see, there are two circles here, and they establish the beginning and the end of the effect. So if I drag this circle all the way down, you can see the text disappears. And if I bring it back, it reappears. But we want an automatic write-on effect. So all we have to do is drag the circle all the way to the left, then choose a point in the text where we want the effect to start, and I want it to start at second one. So I'm gonna set a keyframe here, now I'm gonna go 1 second ahead, and bring the circle all the way to the right, like this. And let's see how it goes. Cool, but I think it's a bit too fast. So to fix that, we can just hit this little arrow right here, and we'll go to the last keyframe. Now we just have to click on it to erase it, we'll go another second ahead, and bring the circle all the way to the right again. Now let's see how it goes. A lot better. But we don't have to stop here. This effect looks even better with the sound effect, and I'm gonna drag it into the timeline. Let's hear how it sounds. Cool, and I'll also leave a link for the free download of this sound effect in the description of the video. Now, let's sync it with our text. Let's drag this to the beginning of the timeline, and let's cut off this part in the beginning. So if I put my mouse here, you can see this arrow appears. Now, we can simply drag this to the right, like this. Let's hear it once again. Okay, now we'll have to put this exactly where the effect starts, right here. And we'll cut it where the effect ends, right here. So now I can give it a little fade out in the end, so it doesn't finish so abruptly. Let's say 2 frames. Let's hear it. And if you like this video, make sure to subscribe to the channel, and let me know in the comments below what types of videos you want me to make. And if you want to learn more editing tricks and hacks inside DaVinci Resolve, make sure to check out this video showing on your screen right now, and I'll see you there.